In this video, I'm going to be talking to you about the Lithe cinema system and how it can transform your living room into an immersive home cinema. The Lithe system is completely wireless. Compared to old installations of AVR systems where you have a black box and you have wires. So with those older systems, it's harder for when it comes to installation or running those cables, or having a central point where the hub has to run up. Whereas the Lithe cinema system is completely wireless, making it really simple when it comes to installation and setup. One is you have easy install. So what that means is you have our range from wireless speakers that can be placed in the ceiling or on wall, and also with a subwoofer as well. With that being completely wireless, you haven't got the hassle of running those cables back to a central location. It's just the case of just adding power. Another one is flexibility, of course, with placement. So depending on the size of your room or where you're looking to install, you have complete flexibility on what speakers you're choosing and where they're going to be positioned. Also with these as well is the high resolution. So with this, you have higher resolution audio, making it completely immersive and making the sound sound absolute its best for that environment and what you're listening to. Another point as well is like scalability and upgradability. So with the different scales that, again, if you're starting quite small, you're not really too sure, and you've only got, say, for example, like a 3-speaker setup, that you think, actually, I want more. I want to fill the room even more with great audio. That can be done. With our system, you can add more speakers in, and because it's all wireless, it makes it really, really simple. And then another point as well, again, is the versatility for movies and music. So it's not just for movies, for example. So the older systems, where you have a hardwired connection, it can only produce what is connected, i.e. from the TV. Whereas with ours, you have that versatility of then adding, doing the movies, music, and also for gaming as well. So anything that is then connected will then output and play audio and being really, really versatile. So that's the sort of difference between our systems and what makes it great. So before we talk about the components for the Lithe cinema system, just going to explain what the numbering sequence means for the surround sound. So for example, when you're doing your research and you're looking at cinema systems and you come across like a number sequence that says like 5.1 or 7.1, and you're not really too sure what that means. So I'm just going to explain exactly what that is. So the first point is going to be your surround. So that's what's going to be on in walls, by your TVs, to your side, to your rears. And that's where it's going to be your 3 speakers, 5 speakers, or 7 speakers. The next point along is going to be a point one, which is going to be for your subwoofer. So that is going to be for the bass, and obviously bring that immersive sound in. Now, the best thing about these speakers, the subwoofer, is you have the ability for stacking. So what's stacking? Stacking literally means stacking one subwoofer on top of another. And that will, of course, give you even more bass and make that really, really rich and bringing in that sound. Now, if you want as well, you could even have another one, another sub on the other side or by the sofa. So there's no sort of cap on these for them. It's just obviously what you're liking in terms of sound. Whereas then the last point, the point two, that's going to be for your high channels. So that's where then the Dolby Atmos kicks in. That's when it is the complete immersive sound where everything is coming in from behind. You're getting different sounds coming in different locations. So that's what that means in terms of, for example, the 5.1, 0.2. So next, I'm just going to go through and we'll talk about those components and where they would sort of be used in this setup. So now we're going to talk about the components of the system. And the first point of your system is going to be the speakers. Now, with our speakers, we have two different versions. So we have our Wi-Fi Pro and we have our Wisa IO1. Now, with both these models, they are high resolution audio to obviously give you that best possible sound, and both are Wisa enabled. And with them as well, of course, they are all in one. So everything's built in: amplifier, speaker, and source. Now, why would you use one? Now, this is all going to depend on your actual installation and obviously where you're looking to install. So if you've got like an open plan kitchen, dining area, somewhere where you want things to be a bit more discreet, then the Pro would be perfect. So with this one, is obviously then installed into the ceiling, and that makes it then really, really discreet. With this, you have a magnetic grill that goes over the top. So once it's installed, it's then really nice and flush. So this would be perfect for that setup. Now, of course, with this system, it's completely wireless with Wisa, meaning you don't have to worry about running those cables. So when it comes to installation, it's in ceiling, out the way, nice and discreet, and it's simply then a wireless connection. Now, if you have, for example, like concrete ceilings, somewhere where it's a bit harder to make that installation, or maybe you're thinking about just doing like a living room space, like a fixed room for that cinema setup. Now, the IR1 is perfect for that. Now, with this one being Wisa enabled, it's the same scenario. So everything is then wireless and will connect to the Wisa system. Now, what makes these really great, as you can see here, this one is then surface mounted. So you still get that nice design and that nice feel and nice look. So if you wanted to have them by the TV, they can be mounted here. You can mount them into the corner. You can then have them pendant from the ceiling as well. So depending on the size, doesn't matter the size of the room or where you're wanting to go, these will be versatile in fitting that space, and along with the Pro as well for them being discreet. And with both being high-res audio and all-in-one and wireless, it makes this whole experience that much simpler. So this is the point one of our system. So this is going to give you the low frequencies, the bass, that kind of that rich sound. Now, as you can see here, it's a really, really nice compact design. And we've also got dual ports on the front here to increase that bass depth. Also as well, that if we then flip it up, we then have our 8-inch paper cone to give you that downward firing, to give you that really high depth of bass. Now with this sub, again, it is completely wireless. So this would just simply link into your in ceilings or on wall speakers. But as you can see here, we've got two ports. Now what this means is that if you have an existing AVR system and you're only looking to maybe add like a little bit of bass to it, this can absolutely be done. So it can be hardwired into the aux in, and can be linked to that older system to produce that bass. It also has an aux out as well. So what that means is you can actually hardwire from sub to sub. So you can daisy chain and stack them up to give you even more bass. Now, when it comes to the flexibility of this as well for placement, you need to ensure that it's going to be at the front of your setup, so by the TV. And as you can see here as well, we have, these are brackets, which are additional extras, which you'd need to purchase. So this allows you to actually mount this onto the wall. So it can be really discreet, really nice design. And again, because it's mounted on the wall, it's still downwards firing. But with this sub, it is absolutely essential for your setup. This is required for your setup to give you that bass, that those low frequencies and that rich sound. Okay, so now we're going to talk about the last point of our setup, and then this is the brain of the system. So choosing which one is right for you. Now, with the traditional AVR systems, going back to our original point, is again the size. So the size we like here, like the PlayStation, really big, then having to have a central location to running all the cables back. Whereas with this digital version, as you can see here, the size is absolute discreet. And what this would do is this, because the speakers are all in one and have a built-in amplifier, you don't need that cable. So then it's done wireless. So all that's doing is then pinging a signal from this puck, from the TV, going up to the speakers and outputting wirelessly. But of course, still giving you that high resolution audio. Now, choosing the right brain, it's all going to depend on what kind of the system setup you have. And as you can see, we've got two versions here. So starting off with this one, this is the sound send puck. Now with this one, this is purely for movies. So on the back here, you see you've got one HDMI ARC port, or you can connect via optical, and then the power. So this one is basic, and what I mean by basic in the sense of it's purely just for movies. So you can't do anything additional. So once this is plugged into your TV's HDMI, eARC, or ARC port, that whatever is then on the TV will output through the speakers. So it's all still done wirelessly. It's all then still high res, but it's just for movies. Whereas here, with the Lithe Audio Cinema Hub, this is a bit more singing or dancing and has those additional extras from what you want. Now, I'll explain with that, and you'll see it's a bit bigger because there's a bit of a bigger brain in here. Whereas this, with the sound send, again, so you still have, in terms of once everything's set up, you have control, you have app control. Now, that means you can change the trim settings and have a little bit of control in terms of your frequencies. Whereas this one here is far more in depth on the ability and what you can do. Now, I'll just go through on the back here. Now, as you can see, we have starting from power. We also have a Ethernet port for data. We have then three HDMI ports. So that means you can connect your games console, your like a TV streaming system, or again, even just the TV directly. So it means that everything is then passing through here. So no matter what is on screen, it will then output through here. And then we have one port here. So then that is then for the eARC connection. Moving down here as well, so we also have optical inputs. So if you have something additional, another speaker system that can be connected and then coming through this box as well. We also have the RCA inputs as well. So again, if you have like a turntable system, something that is essentially hardwired system can be linked to here and then be output through your speaker system. Now with this as well, it also has AirPlay 2, Chromecast, and even Tidal Connect. So when you're going onto your phone device, whether it be AirPlay, Chromecast, Tidal, you look into your app and then you'll see this hub. This hub will pop. So once you connect, that every single speaker that you've added to this system will then output through, and the whole system will then work together at the same time. So this is the remote that is supplied with the Cinema Hub. And we're just going to go through what this thing can do and how it can help you set up your system. So first of all, as you can see on the right-hand side, we have multiple sources. So this goes from our HDMI 1 to 3. We've got our eARC, and we've also got a Bluetooth section as well. And also, if you've got AirPlay, that is then set under Wi-Fi. Now, as you can see here, the remote will light up and tell you what we are on. So at the moment, we are on our settings section. So as you can see on screen here, so from here, this gives you the ability to make changes and configurations for your system. So we're just going to jump into one here and just explain a few and kind of what they do. And you see how easy it is to using this remote to making those changes. So first of all is the speaker layout. Now, as you can see at the moment, it is currently set at 2.0 stereo. Now, this is all going to depend on the size of your room and sort of what system you have. But as you can see how simple it is to make that change, I'm just going to simply select. And now I can go through, I can either have a 7-point system, or if I wanted a complete Dolby Atmos setup of 5.1.2. I just simply press select, and that is it. And it is set. You can see here we've got all of our speakers set up and connected already. Now we'll go into another one here, which is bass management. Now what this does, it changes the high pass and low pass filters. So this will give you the best acoustic possible for each individual speaker. And if we go through another one here, which is channel distance. Now, what this does, it allows you to change the distance for each individual speaker. So if you have a central point on your sofa, that where you're sat, and you want to get the best possible sound, then you can manually adjust that to make it sound absolutely spot on for where you are. So in a nutshell, this one is for just for movies, you know, whether it be your kitchen diner, some of you've got your TV, and then whereas this one is then more for if you, your complete cinema rooms, some room that's going to be dedicated, something that you want the ability to add more, have more games consoles, listen to music, streaming, then this is the right one for you. So those are the difference between the two, and obviously make sure you find the right one. Okay, so now that we've spoken about all sort of three components, now is the point of then combining them all together to create the perfect setup for you. Now, kind of recapping, going back to the start, we're talking about, you know, traditional AVR systems where you have the big old box and running the cables and going throughout, whereas our system is far simpler and wireless to create that really simple installation. Now, as we were saying before, that it doesn't matter what size room you have. It could be a really large living room, really small living room. It could be an open plan kitchen diner. It could even be outside. It doesn't matter what the size is. We have the solution for you. As you saw earlier, with the different boxes and brains, and along with the in-ceiling or IO1s, we can create that cinema system for you. So turning your living room into a home cinema system. However, if you found this a bit complicated or you're not really too sure kind of what you need, don't worry. So we offer a free one-to-one where we will talk and then we will go through exactly what you're looking for, where you're looking to install, the sizings, the whole thing. And we are completely 100% here to help, to advise you right and making sure that you're choosing the right products for your setup. You can find the link in the bottom. And also you'll find links of all the products that we spoke about today. I'm Nathan from Lithe Audio, and I hope you found this video helpful, and I'll see you in the next one.